the early 70s, a time during the Vietnam War. America was invading Vietnam and hoped to stop communism from taking over the country. A time when hippies came about to revolt against the government and to try and make peace with the world. But aside from this conflict, there's a revolution going on that goes unrecognized by most people. Skateboarding became popular during the late 50s. Also known as sidewalk surfing, skateboarding competitions came about and were even aired on national television. But just as things were getting started for skateboarding, skateboarding crashed and seemed to have almost vanished off the face of the earth. There was still hope for skateboarding, as it was being practiced by a young group of kids in the south side of Santa Monica and Venice Beach area, or what the locals referred to as Dogtown. Dogtown was a place where surfing was taken seriously. Back then, society thought of surfers as an eccentric group of people. But the people of Dogtown didn't care. They were comfortable with being outside of the norm and only cared about surfing. But there were times when surfing wasn't always around, especially during the afternoon when the waves died down. So a group of young surfers known as the Zephyr Team improvised and started using skateboards to mimic the moves that they did when surfing and applied them to concrete. The Zephyr Team was brought up by the owners of the Jeff Ho and Zephyr Surfboard Productions store. Skip Anglum, Craig Stizek, and Jeff Ho not only made the surfboards by hand, but also tested them out on the waves. They really pushed the team so that they can help them reach their full potential. They also served as a parent figure to the team because some of the kids came from poverty or broken homes. Back then, there were no skateboard manufacturers that made skateboards since the crash of the 1960s. But the Zephyr Team managed to make their own by taking clay wheels from roller skates and nailing them to a solid piece of oak that they cut out in the shape of a small surfboard. Not much could be possible using clay wheels on a skateboard. But in 1972, a man by the name of Frank Nasworthy came up with the idea to use urethane instead of clay wheels and created Cadillac wheels. This idea turned out to be a success. Companies started making skateboards again. People were more involved in skateboarding and it opened a huge window on what skateboarding could become. For the Z-Boys, skating was now taken much more seriously. The Z-Boys, unlike other skate teams of that time, wanted to create their own unique way of skateboarding with their own unique style. With skateboarding becoming more popular, skateboard competitions were made as well as skate teams. The Z-Boys decided to also create their own team specifically for skateboarding. They were Shogo Kubo, Bob Biniak, Nathan Pratt, Stacy Peralta, Jim Muir, Alan Sarlow, Chris Cahill, Tony Alva, Wenzel Rummel, Peggy Oki, Jay Adams, and Paul Constantino. This group of skaters would go around the city and search for places to skate, mostly at schools where there were banks perfect for their style of skating. During the Z-Boys' time of skating, there was a serious drought in California. Swimming pools, which were popular in California, were drying up. The Z-Boys saw this as an opportunity and were one of the first group of kids to skate in pools. This was the birth of vertical skating. Much more was possible when skating in pools. Kids were carving a pool the same way they would carve a wave. They would come up to the lip of the pool, have one wheel on the coping, and come back down. Skaters would come all across town and search for empty pools to skate in. Most pools were filthy and were filled with dirt, water, and all other sorts of debris. Skaters were so dedicated to riding these pools that they would clean the pools out with pool pumps, brooms, and anything else you needed to clean a pool. They had to do this quickly so that they can have more time skating, since they didn't know when the cops or the owners of the property would show up. Skaters were risking being charged with trespassing or being fined a large amount of money. Part of the thrill of skating at pools was the fact that you can get caught at any given time. These young and talented skaters decided to put their skills to the test and entered the Del Mar National Skateboarding Competition of 1975. It was a freestyle competition on a flat surface. The Z-Boys were up against skaters with a 60s classical type of skating, mostly upright maneuvers and manuals. The first member of the Z-Boys to go first was Jay Adams. He showed the judges what the Z-Boys were about, a low, aggressive style of skateboarding. No one in the audience had seen this type of skating. People were impressed and so were the judges. Jay Adams and Tony Alva took third and fourth in the freestyle, and Peggy Oki took first in the women's freestyle. Although the Z-Boys didn't place first, it didn't matter to them. They were just there to make a name for themselves and introduce their new style of skating. The Z-Boys are now known and were approached by many skateboard manufacturer sponsors. Skateboarding boomed and the magazines such as Skateboarder were published throughout the country. It even featured the Z-Boys in its articles. For the Z-Boys, the fame and money that came along broke the team up and they split into different branches. Stacy and Jay went off making their own skateboard company, Alva Skates and Powell Peralta. And as for the rest of the team, they stuck with skating locally and surfing. If it hadn't been for the Z-Boys, there would be no such thing as ramps, bowls, or vert skating. They passed down a message to future generations of skaters that skateboarding has no boundaries. People can skate however they want and should explore many different ways of skating. Skateboarding today has revolutionized by many different shapes of skateboards and street skating. Skateboarding is alive and well, and who knows if there will be another skate revolution in the future.